What's up, guys? I'm excited for today's lesson because we're going to be talking about while loops. And loops in general are just super useful for us. They allow us to repeat lines of code based on some condition, which allows us to do some really cool things. So I'll show you what I mean. So I like starting off with examples. So let's just say I want you to print day 0. And then what if I told you to print day 1 and 2 after that? Well, that's not much harder. We can even copy and paste to make it a little easier on ourselves. So if we run this, we can just see day 0, 1, and 2 print out. So that's fine, but what if we wanted to print out 30 days? What if we wanted to print out 3,000 days? We don't want to make a new line, a new print line for every single one of those days. That would take forever. So this is where while loops come in. So let me show you what we can do. So loops allow us to repeat lines of code based on some condition. So what I want to do is I want to make a variable that has counted how many times my loop has ran. And then I'm going to say, if my loop has ran less than 5 times, keep going. If it has ran that many times, then stop. So here's what I mean. So I'm going to make a counter variable. So I'll say counter is equal to 0. And then I want to use a while loop. So I say while some condition is true, do something. So this condition, this is just crap I threw up there. So this condition is when we want to continue our loop. So if this condition is true, keep looping. If it's false, stop looping. So I want to say while my counter variable, while my loop has ran less than 5 times, do something. So what is this something? Well, I want to print out this day. So I'm going to cut this and paste it here. And I'll delete that other stuff just to not confuse anyone. And now I have to change my counter. So right now, this is saying while 0 is less than 5, that's always true. My loop will never be false. So what we have to do is every time our loop runs, I want to say that counter has a new value and is equal to the old value plus 1. So if we run this, we can see day 0 prints out 5 times. And here's what's happening. So we start off by saying counter is 0. And then when we start our loop, we check our condition. Is 0 less than 5? It is. So we run our loop. So we print day 0 and we add 1 to counter. And then once we get to the end of this indented section, and the indention is what lets us know that these lines of code belong to this while loop. So once we get to the end of this indented section, we jump back up to this line. And then we check this condition again. So now counter holds a value of 1. So is 1 less than 5? It is. So we print day 0 again, add 1 to counter. We get to the end, which means we hop back up here. Counter is now 2. Is 2 less than 5? Run this. Is 3 less than 5? Run this. Is 4 less than 5? Run this. And finally, we get to. Is 5 less than 5? No, it's not. So then our code would continue down, not indented. We'd just keep running through our lines of code. So now for the last piece of this, we don't want this to say day 0 every time. We want to say day 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So instead of printing, just straight day 0, I'm going to delete that and I'm going to add or concatenate this string equivalent of counter. So we know that counter starts off at 0, then it goes to 1, then 2, then 3, and that's exactly what we want our days to do. So if we run this, you can see day 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So here's where it gets cool. Let's say I wanted to print 50 days and just add a 0 there, run it again, boom. Instantly, I have so much more done for me with one more keystroke. I could even say 500 days, it doesn't matter. I can just add so much functionality and my code can do so much more work for me with a few keystrokes. And that's why while loops is so cool. I've got a lot more cool things coming for you guys. Thanks for watching.